UFC's final match in the legendary George the Hitman Julio's career, and is set inside this steel cage. Introducing first the special guest referee, Daniel Beaumont. Introducing first,
and the door is locked, and the four men are in the ring. Trevor. And George, the Hitman Julio Trevor, sir, he's not starting off light, he's going in heavy.
George, that I'm spinning in the crazy face.
Well, you've got four superstars in the ring. And veteran move by Lobo, of course. Saw the drop kick coming, anticipated and got out of the way.
Altered his step. Oh! Mad Dog just drops George. And drops the elbow across the chest.
Well, that absolutely devastating. Oh! Elbow across the chest. And the trash can lid right between the eyes of Lobo. Oh,
welcome back to the to New Age Wrestling, Lobo.
Ah, sensational stuff.
And that's exactly it. Like, George the Hitman Julio looking to a man who hasn't been seen in a wrestling ring for quite some time in Lobo. And, oh, head first into the table leg there.
And a metal leg hitting Lobo right in the face.
Well, four seasoned veterans all know what they're doing, and a seasoned veteran in the referee and Daniel Beaumont, such is the occasion that brings these men. But such is a match, Travis and Sean, that it had to be contained in a steel cage.
Well, the thick tensions have been building up between Julio and Mad Dog McCray. It was a King of the Cage War Games in June that Mad Dog issued a challenge to Hitman before he retires one more match. Unfortunately, that match happened last month and Mad Dog snapped and tried to end the career of Hitman a month early.
Oh! And Lobo just sneaking up on the enforcer.
Hang on.
Oh, here we go, watch out! Oh, goodness!
Huge back body drop, turning the enforcer inside out. What a way to have a final exclamation point on such a legendary career like George's.
What a sensational move from the top turnbuckle. And the enforcer flat as a pancake as Lobo gets his hands on the steel chair.
Hang on, Mad Dog's got a screwdriver and he was stabbing him in the forehead with it. And that chair shot just broke the chair completely over Mad Dog.
Well, there you are, there's the screwdriver on the edge of the apron. Referee didn't see it, but it is a hardcore cage match, so pretty much anything goes.
Lobo checking on George, making sure that he's all right.
Currently in this ring are three of George Julio's greatest students. Hitman trained all three men in this matchup.
Mad Dog McCray in a whole host of trouble. Enforcer slowly getting up to his feet as Vixen looks on from outside of the ring.
Enforcer's coming against Lobo.
Oh, we're looking at George far up now. Oh, knuckle sandwich, open knuckle sandwich. He's opened up Mad Dog McCray. Feel across to the center of the ring. Oh, look at that, into the cage. Back body drop by the enforcer. And Sean and Travis, this is some hardcore old school action.
It sure is. You wouldn't expect anything less George Julio's final match.
Exactly, and Mad Dog and Lobo, no strangers to each other, having countless hardcore battles in the past. And
well, they are legends of the hardcore style.
Exactly right.
A little bit of claret on the face of McCray, but that's only going to fire him up. Oh, as Lobo goes right into that bridging panel.
Just like Hitman did moments earlier.
Absolutely. Hitman down in a little bit of trouble. All four men in the ring,
hip toss,
and the enforcer
between the cage wall.
And that hurts, as you know, Travis. And if you don't know, we can demonstrate later.
I'd rather not. Oh, big headbutt.
Oh, look at this. Like two wild deer.
These two bloody men.
I was going to say locking horns, but that probably inappropriate.
I believe this match can only be won by pinfall or submission.
Pinfall or submission, escaping the cage will not win it. Look at these two legends go. Oh!
Mad Dog dropped on the top rope between the legs.
George, I tell you what, that'll make his voice higher than mine. Oh, Lobo, sensational stuff. Oh, have a look at George.
Oh, look, Enforcer is busted open by George Julio.
Well, they're all busted open at this stage. They've all got claret on them, but have a look at George. And hasn't he come out a house of fire tonight, George Julio?
Well, the challenge that Mad Dog made in June was the challenge that inspired Hitman to return to action. He's taken on the likes of Marcus Bullseye Blake and Slade Mercer.
Well, I tell you, I've known George for 26 years and I've called a lot of his matches. I don't think I've seen him quite so intense as he is in this match.
He might be a 70-year-old man, but he's moving around in the ring like he's in his 40s. Hitman is going all out.
Oh, McRae face first into the steel bars there. The enforcer being choked out with that trash can lid. Oh,
and he German suplexes Lobo.
Oh,
head smacking back into that steel cage.
That should have shown him. You see the Hitman this intense?
Not for a very long time, Peter. That's exactly it. This cage has very little give. It is a hard, hard cage. And all four men being thrown into it. It's not a nice thing to have happen to you. George has just been on fire, but all four men
look at that. Sleep with that.
Enforcer using spring awareness, giving all the three other competitors some form of a jawbreaker there. Enforcer being the only one pretty much.
Oh, the Enforcer calling for something.
Well, now we know why Vixen's out here. She's here to give a helping hand to the Enforcer and Mad Dog.
He has handcuffed George the Hitman, Julio.
Oh, come on.
The Enforcer with the handcuffs. Looks like he's going to handcuff George to the cage.
It's George's final match and Enforcer has to resort to tactics.
Oh!
Using handcuffs?
They are handcuffs. He has been handcuffed to the side of the cage and the Enforcer and Mad Dog McRae just having their way with him now.
That's right.
Absolutely despicable actions on the part of McRae and the Enforcer.
Leg drop onto that trash can, onto the back of Lobo. And that is
career ending stuff.
Lobo specifically coming back for this match, coming to the aid of his mentor, George Julio.
Well, he was trying to, but he's being taken care of by the Enforcer, and George Hitman Julio with nowhere to go, no escape. Oh, this is not going to be good.
Oh, now, choking George with that steel chair in the
Come throat. On, referee Daniel Beaumont, do something. I don't know what, but do something.
Sure, the midsection. What's Lobo thinking here?
Oh!
The top tornado right onto that trash can.
I tell you what, none of these guys are going to walk out unaided from this match tonight.
Absolutely right, Peter.
What a sensational main event.
This is going to be a war.
Well, it already is. It is a war. And a war of attrition as well.
Look at the referee here helping George get unhandcuffed from the cage wall.
Well, they're trying to get those handcuffs off. Vixen trying to stop that happening. But, I think the referee's finally got...
Apparently she's helping.
She's helping. Well, if she wanted to help, why'd she give them the handcuffs in the first place?
I'm not going to argue with her.
No, I wouldn't argue with her either, but I'm sitting in between you two. I figure I've got time to get out of here before she gets to me.
The Enforcer and Mad Dog with the double. And he landed on that trash can lid.
I tell you what, that trash can lid's taken more punishment than all the reasons. Oh, but George is free!
George is back and he's on fire! Rose line!
Oh, elbow! And the Hitman's fired up! Picks it up! Oh,
George!
A reverse Samoan drop! Picks it up now! Just dumps him on the side! George Hitman Julio, a house of fire, and Lobo all over the Enforcer.
George Hitman possessed.
He is, isn't he? What a great word, Sean. He's possessed tonight.
George wants to end his career on a high note with a big victory.
He's going to. He may possibly end with a big victory, but he's going to end up with a lot of big bruises.
Wait a minute.
Oh, here we go.
Wait a minute.
Shades of the Road Warriors.
It's been a long time since Hitman's gone up top.
Oh! Give it up for the Hitman!
Beautiful. I said, and his age hasn't done that in a long time. He's throwing out all the stops in his final.
I tell you what, we must bring
him. Come up.
Mad Dog kicks out.
I think we're going to need to start a petition to stop him retiring. I reckon he could go another 10 years.
Believe me, he would.
Yes, I know he would. Oh, this is sensational. What an honour it is to be part of such a historic evening and to witness an absolute living legend doing his thing in a hardcore steel cage match.
Oh, hang on. What is Mad Dog doing? He's looks like he's setting up that table.
Well, he is, and it can't be good.
Come on, George! Yeah! Oh, Hobo just kicked that trash can right in the face of the enforcer.
Well, we do have ambulance people on standby, and I reckon one of them's going to need it. Oh, look at that. Knuckle sandwich. No one to the side of the throat. And again, George. And again, as he fires up. Oh, don't tell me.
Julio.
Oh no. He may well have busted his ankle on that. The table's given way as he's come down, but it hasn't stopped the enforcer and Mad Dog McRae taking advantage. Hitman's in a bad way.
I don't think his legs are working right now.
No,
it was a bad landing for George.
It was a very bad landing. This is not good.
Oh. Come on, George!
Uh-oh.
Enforcer, we're going to be dangerous.
Dropping George right off the table.
Oh! And the
rest of it. It's over.
And yes, he told us, ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, Mad Dog McRae and the Enforcer.
Incredible tag team cage match. What a main event.
What a main event. What a victory. What a match. What a legend. George the Hitman Julio. As all the boys come out to show their respect, all the current legends,
I thank you people, you made me And how do you say? I'm very happy. I thank everybody. You made me and you made these blocks, and we die for you. Every wrestler here, he killed himself for you people. And look, I thank you. I thank everybody, you know. I thank my daughter, my grandson. Yeah. And wrestling, without you people, we are nothing. You make us do what we have to do. We die for you. These people, they get hurt for you, to give you fun. All right? Look, I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Now, understand me. This is all guys here around the ring. They die for you to give you entertainment. Look, what I'm gonna say anymore. Just I wanna thank you people. Thank you. And I love these vlogs. They die for me. All of them. I stood that long because these guys, they understand. Even in the ring, they helped me. I didn't done this match by myself. These people work hard to don't hurt me. All right, they look after me. All right, but I love them all. And I love the crowd, I love the people. We need more people to, I'm not saying only the show, all the shows in Australia. All right, I thank you very much. I can't say no more.
Thank you, I can say to you from the bottom of my heart is that I have no idea where I'd be if I wasn't here right now. Maybe somewhere shit, maybe somewhere bad, maybe somewhere good. But before wrestling, I had nothing. I met you. I didn't know anything. Zilch, zero in life, zero in wrestling. You took me from nothing and made me something. To stand here in the ring with you, the guy who took me as a 16-year-old kid and taught me to fight, taught me to be a wrestler, and taught me how to be a fucking man in and around the ring. It means more to me than you can ever imagine. And to stand here in the ring with the guy who taught me how to wrestle, and the guy who taught me how to be crazy, and the guy who taught me some restraint, and Ken, wherever he is, the guy who gave me a chance to do it. But to stand here in the ring with you, George, now in front of everyone, holy shit, man, it breaks my heart.
Yeah.
I wish I could have 100 more matches with you.
I'll keep this short and sweet.
This is the closing of a chapter of a book that will literally never be written again. And from the bottom of my heart, and I think I speak for everybody, we love you and thank you for every ounce of blood that you bled, every tear that you shed, every drop of sweat that you also dropped for everybody. We absolutely respect everything you've done. So thank you, George.
Thank you. Thank you very much, man. Thank you.
George, the man who made me do a moonsault onto a concrete first day of my training. Thank you, George. Bye. Always respect.
What do you want me to say? I thank you, audience. And... I want to say something. All right, the last thing. It's, I don't want to say only NFW. You understand? You need to follow every promotion in Australia. All right? Because all the wrestlers, we are family. We respect each other. All right? That's what, look, thank you very much. Thank you very much, people. All right?
more.